Guys, and welcome back to Tuesday. Here I am. I hope you all had a good week, and I hope Tuesday finds you well and happy and stuff. For those of you who watched my video last week and are wondering how it went with the tube strike in London, I was fine. Weirdly, I had much less trouble than I was anticipating. I got my one national rail train service to Liverpool Street Station and walked the rest of the way. It was actually quite fun and nice and a kind of relaxing stroll start to the day. I had to set off earlier, but yeah. So my worries, as my worries sometimes are, particularly with whether I get to work on time or not, were unfounded. But thank you for all of you who wish me luck in getting there. It's appreciated. I was worried, and you wishing me luck. Sorry, I'm all sweaty because it's really hot again here today. And yeah, you wishing me luck, you guys wishing me luck, really meant a lot to me, so thank you. On to today's question. Here it is, I've got it on my computer, a la a newsreader, typing. Question this week was set by Carson, and it's a brilliant question. It's quite a highbrow question, and as such, I do apologise, A, if I apologise so much for apologising about this, but I also apologise if I'm not highbrow enough, and if my answer to this is a bit shallow, but here we go. Who's your favourite transgender and or queer artist, and why? I'm defining artists broadly here to include visual arts, filmmakers, singers, writers, actors, etc. Great question. Wonderful question. The people who Carson mentions here, I think, are some of the most admirable people in our society. I mean, yes, firefighters, doctors, etc., etc., are admirable. And all kinds of people are admirable for all kinds of reasons. But people who engage in the arts like that... I so wish I could do that. I often find that, I think, when I try and do that, I find I hit a brick wall. Maybe I'm too self-conscious about it, but I wish I could sing, or write, or really draw, or act. Maybe I could act, I don't know. So yeah, as such, I want to do this question so much justice. Not sure if I'm gonna. Okay, in looking at this, I know there are loads of trans and queer people engaged in the arts, but I hit a brick wall in thinking of lots of people, really interestingly. But, nevertheless, to start with, on Sunday, Mila and Jaina, being comic book people, like I am, mentioned a lot of people I was going to mention, of course. It was great to see you guys again, if you're watching this. Brilliant, it was brilliant to have them back for a week, for 1 week, wasn't it? Cool. So yeah, those people they mentioned. Other people I could possibly mention, there are loads. people like Gwen Harworth, if any of you have seen the documentary She's a Boy and You. Wonderful. I pick her out to mention because she's a lesbian identified trans woman like me, who did this documentary. If those of you out there don't know, you probably all do though, kind of chronicling her family's reaction to her transition. It's like their story, a really kind of close up to their kind of raw feelings about her transition. And of course she did it with such wit and humility. I know if I was just coming out that that film would have meant a lot to me. And it still does. She's really cool. Really cool rocking kind of person. Other people who are trans and engaged in the arts, off the top of my head, probably didn't do as much preparation for this as I should have. Sorry. My voice is getting hoarse and raspy. And I haven't got any drink. Sorry. yeah, people like, right off the top of my head, and written down in my little diary. Photographer Lauren Cameron, and his kind of chronicling of trans people in photography, really interesting. There's a dance group, music group, called, I believe they're called Hercules and Love Affair. And one of the people in that, one of the women in that, is trans, and they're quite cool. Not my kind of music, but that's really cool. They got a bit of kind of more mainstream press coverage in the UK last year, and as such, kind of struck me. Writer Rachel Pollack, to get my extra comic-y reference in here, who wrote the DC comic book The Doom Patrol in the mid-90s for a brief while. Writer. I have to pick as my favourite trans artist in a broad sense. Have to pick, even though she was mentioned on Sunday, Julia Serrano. Have to, because she's cool. Because, like Gwen Harworth, lesbian identified trans woman, just like me, empowering for me to see her out there doing a lot, fighting for our inclusion in women's spaces. Also, when I showed my mother her spoken word pieces, the one that's on YouTube, Cocky, I feel it brought kind of a new level of connection and communication between my mother and I about my transness, simply because my mum is into poetry, that kind of thing, and saw it and was kind of blown away by that as a spoken word piece, regardless of the fact it was about trans stuff. And as such, that I felt, I haven't ever told this to my mum before, but I felt that kind of made us, for me, communication with my mum about my transness kind of click to a new depth. And that means so much to me. And of course, Julia Serrano's book, Whipping Girl, really cool book. But for in a similar way, helped me connect, I think, with my mum in a way of understanding about my transness. Not that my mum wasn't supportive before, because she was, but it gave us that extra level of depth, I feel, in understanding other queer people. I'm going to sound so shallow picking this, but film director Catherine Brooks, I love. She's a film director. There's a couple of her short films you can find on YouTube. Dear Emily, Finding Kate. She has this thing of naming films, seemingly describing word and woman's name. Famously did the film Loving Annabelle, about an inappropriate relationship between a Catholic schoolgirl and her teacher. Dodgy subject, but it's so emotive, it's so emo and wonderful, and a guilty pleasure as far as films for me. Meaningful silences and beautifully shot, and I had to mention that. Being the British person on Tranny Star, I had to mention as well our new Poet Laureate. The Poet Laureate in the UK is a position appointed by the government, by the Crown, to be a poet who would create, shockingly, poetry about things to kind of chronicle the goings on in the nation through poetry. Our new Poet Laureate very recently is a woman by the name of Carol Ann Duffy, who is Britain's first female and also first openly gay Poet Laureate. As such, I have to give her a mention. Now, my mother, mentioning my mum again, loves her work. And as such, I'm going to call her and get her to tell you by the phone a little bit about Caroline Duffy, if we have got time, which I believe we have. Because my mum can say so much. This is what she does. She's quite deep and kind of into this kind of thing. She's an artsy person. And here she is. Hi, Mum. You are live on Tranny Star Galactica. I'm going to put you on speakerphone and you can say hello to the viewers. Hold on. Hold on, folks. Okay, Mum, go ahead.
Hi, it's me. Hello, everyone. Carol wants me to say something about Caroline Duffy, because I really love her poetry an awful lot. Now, I suppose I really love her because of the way her poetry seems quite kind of physical. and almost visceral sometimes. You know, she chooses things as if the world is her oyster. She goes into all sorts of strange yet somehow familiar worlds, and I love that, being a drama person, because I can see kind of things that touch me myself personally, and I recognise in other people in what she says. She goes into the mythic and the fabulous and popular imagery too, and she uses language, sometimes it's almost like she turns it upside down. I like her directness.
I might have to cut you short there, Mum, because we're coming up on 10 minutes.
Sure, okay. Well, a good book to read is Carol Ann Duffy Picador Poetry. I really like that. New Selected Poems, 84 to 2004.
Brilliant.
So if you get the chance, read them, folks. They're
yeah.
Really
good. So do look up that book, guys. Have you got anything quick you'd like to say to the viewers of Tranny Star?
Yeah. Hey, everybody. I send you all a big hug. I've got nothing else to say but that. It's quite pathetic, but there you go.
No, it's not. It's lovely, Mum. Thank you.
Oh, that's okay.
Cool. I'll call you back in a moment, and thank you. I'm sure everybody appreciates that, because you've brought a level of highbrowness to this video that would have been absent otherwise. I'll talk to you in about 10 minutes. Bye.
Bye.
Bye. There you go. I think we're just about done. I will see you all next week. I hope that was interesting enough. It was interesting hearing my mum, I think. Talk to you later. Bye. See you next week.